Greetings, people of Paul Muckle here. Today is September 7, 2013 at 9:50 a.m. Eastern Time. People, what you're looking at here right now is this star Sirius, right? And we see Orion system, right? Okay. Now, I know there's a lot of video going around on YouTube about Comet Ison and about Nibiru, Planet X. You know, they're telling us about all the doomsday scenario coming to crash into Earth, and they're going to destroy us, and January 2014 not going to exist. Now, people, do you know what is traveling with our sun? Look at it, Sirius and the Orion system is traveling with our sun. They are so close to our sun right now, and that's what these people are seeing and lying to you guys and spreading out the doomsday. I'm not saying Comet Ison is not real, I'm not saying that. But some of the images that you all are seeing and they're telling you all are these doomsday stuff. Is the planet Sirius star, our sun's companion? Sirius, people, is our sun's companion, okay? This is our sun's companion. The Egyptian knew it and the ancient knew it. That Sirius is our sun's companion, our sun's binary. I believe that. So anyway, it's daylight, people. Okay, and look at Sirius right here. In the daylight, it's traveling with our sun. So this is what causing the stuff that you are saying, all this magnetic, whatever it is you are saying going on. It's the Orion system that's doing it, and Sirius. Okay, I might not get it back again because it was so hard to get because it's so bright out, but I'm gonna go to the sun right now. Okay. You can't even see when I feel it out. Sun is coming up. Okay. Let's see if I can get it back again. So seriously traveling with the sun. I got it a couple of shots of it earlier, about a couple of hours ago, 2 hours ago maybe. I'm gonna show them to you guys. This is Sirius here, and it's traveling with our sun. It's our sun's companion, it's binary. Focus, focus, focus. Okay. I think I'm gonna lose him right now, so anyway, people, don't believe that any object is coming to destroy our Earth. I don't believe that, okay? These dooms still being saying it forever. It's first one, 2012, it's every year. It's gonna be some doomsday. It's gonna be Armageddon, and Earth's gonna be wiped out of creation. Come on, they've been around for billions of years, I'm sure. Okay, maybe not billions, but Earth is probably a relatively young planet, but it's been around, and we are protected by our moon and by our sun. Okay, so that's serious day now. We see how the sun coming up. I'm gonna lose him. I'm not gonna get him again. So the sun's coming up between the gates. Okay. So the sun just comes out over the horizon. I doubt if I ever get to see this again. Let me try. Anyway. Maybe it's in the camera, but I just can't see it. Anyway, I'm all people, one love, one heart, one destiny for all humanity. And our destiny is not gonna be destruction by Comet Ison or any other comet. Our destiny is ascension. Okay, so one destiny for all humanity, and I'm out. Finally got the Orion belt. Elusive. You see me trying to get them. Okay, people have the Orion system right here, right? That's the Orion belt right there. To lose them again. Keep the Orion belt right here. Whatever. I don't know how much I could get, but there's so many stars out here, people. The Orion belt, the Big Dipper, the Little Dipper. They are Orion system. See if they are right here in the same, right, same vicinity. This is, I don't know what star this is. I think it's in there. I have two stars, I forget the name of this one, I've seen it before. There's so many of them, people. Big Dipper, Little Dipper, Sirius Orion. The one next to each post, I don't know if you can see them. They're kind of tiny though. One next to each post. The Orion belt is so hard to get, it's elusive. I need a camera where I could capture all of them in one shot. That would be great if I could capture the whole scene in one shot. It is so beautiful, people. Yeah, I don't know if I want to get the Orion belt again. I don't have the patience right now. Anyway, that's it for now. Well, okay, here's a better shot, people. This time I got serious in the picture this time. Really flashing. Okay, need a better shot. They see us right here coming up over the horizon. He sees. They did disappear too. What's going on here? Okay. here, trying to disappear into the mist. Come on, focus. Focus. Okay, there you go. Okay, you can see it's right at the bottom, right? Hey Sirius, long time no see. It's been quite a while, Papa. Okay, so let's see it's right then above it. Let's see if I can get the Orion belt. Get the Orion belt right above. Got you. Orion belt. I was about to give up though. Let's hear them right there. This Orion system. I'm done. I can't see this one time before I go. Are you serious? The belt is too elusive. Focus. It's my style right here. See, it's on the sun. Oh, people, also forget to mention, right, there's one of the stars traveling with the Orion system. It's strange, it's like, it's very bright and they have two other stars traveling with it. It's closer to the sun than Sirius is. And maybe that's what they're calling Nibiru, Comet Ice now, whatever, but it's very bright and it's closer to the sun. And it's right close to Betelgeuse in the Orion system. It's very bright, so I don't know if that's the star that is causing whatever disturbance on the sun. But it's very big and it's very bright. So, who knows? Perhaps Sirius is planet is Nibiru, because that's where the Anunnaki came from. From Sirius, and some of those aliens, the Dracos or whatever, came from Orion. The reptilians probably came from Orion. But anyway, Sirius and Orion have a lot to do with life here on Earth. Okay, so the Egyptians spoke about Sirius a lot, and the Anunnaki and Egyptians are very, their culture are very related. So if this, if the Egyptians spoke about the Sirius so much and didn't mention Nibiru, and the Anunnaki mentioned Nibiru, and the Egyptians got their culture from the Anunnaki, then doesn't it make sense that Sirius could be Nibiru? Another thing, people, we know that Sirius B is, they say, pure metal, right? Pure metal. And they said that Nibiru was the 10th planet, right? Now we know between Mars and Jupiter, there's like a 35 or 55 million space where the asteroid belts are, you know, the minor planets. And you know, before the ancients, and in 1800s and the 1700s, they had a belief that there was a planet there, and the planet got destroyed. And the minor planets and the asteroid belts, those are the remnants of that 10th planet, which would be Nibiru. Scientists today are discrediting that, however, people, because they're saying the explosion would have caused a catastrophe. But people, it didn't have to be an explosion. What if Sirius B, this heavy metal, crashed into that 10th planet? It would break into pieces, but it don't have to be an explosion. You just crack it and it broke into pieces. Why did it have to be an explosion? So the minor planets and the asteroid belts, you know, Vesta and those planets, they could have been part of Nibiru, the 10th planet, and Sirius B crashed into it and destroyed it. So something to think about, you know, food for thought. So will there something crash into Earth? I take it back, it could happen, but I think we are protected. So Sirius B could have crashed into the 10th planet and destroyed it, crashed into Nibiru and destroyed it. But some would have escaped, because remember, some of the Anunnaki was on the moon and on Mars and on Earth at the time. So if Nibiru was destroyed, all the Anunnaki didn't get destroyed with it. Okay, so Paul McCall here, and I'm out. Food for thought. Anyway, I'm out, people. One love, one heart, one destiny for all humanity. And our destiny is not gonna be destruction by Comet Ison or any other comet. Our destiny is ascension. One destiny for humanity, and I'm out.